Vladislav Alexandrovich Tretiak. 32 years old, a Red Army major, 3 times an Olympic champion,
10 times a world champion.
A Soviet master of sport with the endurance, speed, and flourish of a Cossack. He has a dream to be a Soviet in the NHL.
Edmonton. The Soviet goaltender, Vladislav Tretiak, emerges for practice. A photographer wants Tretiak and Wayne Gretzky in the same shot. If he gets it, it's certain front page.
Tretiak is suffering jet lag and a slight fever, but Gretzky hopes he will be in the net when their teams face off in a few hours.
Okay, there you go. He's got to practice. I'll see you after. Where's the interpreter? No, no, no.
Yes, okay. Okay,
so I'll send for him after.
They're friends, but Wayne has a score to settle. Coach Viktor Tikhonov has a warning for his All-Stars. Don't let Gretzky and the Oilers humiliate Soviet hockey. But Tikhonov decides to rest his premier goaltender, gambling he can beat Gretzky and the Oilers without Tretiak. He controls the pace, mesmerizing the opposition with split-second pauses at the top of his shot. Gretzky administers the coup de grace, and the Oilers win 4-3. Gretzky says the absence of Tretiak from the Soviet goal undoubtedly made the difference. Returning the compliment, Tretiak says there is one thing which makes Gretzky stand out from most NHLers.
His head, his brains.
In the Soviet Union, all specialists, and myself personally, all the guys think that he's a European-style hockey player. What does that mean? It means he's not a crude, rough player. He's a thinking type of player. He's not predictable as many of your hockey players are.
In 1962, when Gretzky was but one, a scrawny 10-year-old from a Moscow suburb arrived for a tryout at the Central Red Army Sports Club. Vladislav Tretiak's father was Air Force, but it was his mother who had the right connections. She taught here in the phys ed program, so he was among the 1,000 who try out every year. Only 70 are selected. Young Tretiak was a forward who could skate like the wind, so they kept him. He had 2 dreams. The first was to wear on his chest the red star of the Soviet national team. But his first team had too many players and not enough sweaters. They also had no goaltender. "Give me a sweater," said Tretiak, "and I'll be the goaltender." In the beginning, he was so scared he closed his eyes when the shooting began. But by the age of 15, he was backup goaltender for the Red Army. 2 years later, he was number one. His second dream was to play the Canadian professionals and beat them.
The international hockey match between Team Canada and the Soviet Union is declared open.
The opportunity came in 1972. The profits were unanimous. The Canadian professionals were going to blow the Soviets into Hudson Bay. It was the Canadians who were shocked. Losing 3 games, fighting back to win 3, and playing 1 to a tie.
Kill him, kill him! Put him in the corner, that's right, Red.
Park is trying to come out on the left side. A long pass to Phil Esposito going in.
As he had throughout the series, the 20-year-old Tretyak played brilliantly. 90% of the country tuned in, including a former prime minister.
Oh, that was a back shot.
Now.
5-0-2. Left in the game. A 5-0 tie.
One more goal would win it. That seemed an impossible dream.
By Tretyak. Bernoye has it on that wing. Here's a shot. Henderson made a wild stab where it fell. Here's another shot. Right by the door.
Tretyak still has nightmares of the climactic moment. Twice the shot came, and twice he made the save. But his defenseman had been drawn away. In 1972, Canada won the battle. But the Soviets have since won the war. Tretyak's substantial collection of pins and medals boast of an almost unrelenting Soviet victory in international play. The 1980 Olympics were a dramatic exception.
5 seconds left in the game. Do you believe in miracles? Yes!
Tretyak punishes himself after defeat. Defeat, says Tretyak, makes him physically ill. He says a goalie has only one commandment, to stop the puck. Because a play unfolds in the wink of an eye, he says a goalie has no time to react. The goalie must see the play as if in slow motion and know where the puck is going ahead of time. He went on to become the most valuable player as the Soviets won the next world championship. But in the championship game, they now face Tretyak, who crosses himself like an old Montreal Canadian. And on this night, God sides with the Russians. Time and time again, Team Canada is stopped by the magnificent major.
Tretyak with a tremendous
and he set the shot. It's right on.
And it's locked Tretyak
at his best.
Van hammering it in behind the net for Bossy. In the final minute of play now, and it's loose in front. The shot right on. Did he score?
By Dennis Potvin. He usually scores in the NHL on shots like that. Not so. Tretyak again.
Gretzky moving in deep. Gretzky and a weak pass out in front.
In this game, even Gretzky gives the puck away.
Krutov and LaFleur back. Sports off, 2-on-1, down over the line, the shot, he scores, and it's 8-1.
Vladislav Tretyak.
Well, there's the outstanding player for the Soviets, and we mentioned it near the end of the game. I thought the key performance in the game was that first period that Tretyak put in.
Now it's Tretyak's turn to gather the laurels. The Soviets take home the Canada Cup. The Gretzkys decide to follow, accepting an invitation from the Soviet Ice Hockey Federation to investigate the inner workings of the Red Army system. Wayne is curious how a Red Army superstar lives and works. Tretyak and his family give up a large part of their vacation to play host to the Gretzky family. Wayne carries a letter from Prime Minister Trudeau, naming him a hockey ambassador.
How are you? My father, Walter.
For Walter, it's also a voyage to his father's native land.
We're very happy that you came to meet us today. It's an honor for us.
They come to a Moscow warmed by June sunshine and are installed in the 5,000-room Hotel Russia in a prime location across from the Kremlin and Red Square. Hockey in North America is run by the owners in conjunction with Allen Eagleson and the Players Association. Here, it's the Red Army and the Communist Party.
That's the star they got for their flag.
You have to watch and study in there. Почему? Потому что во время Великой Отечественной войны погибло 20 миллионов русских людей.
Because during the last war, 20 millions of the Soviet people died on the battles.
Tretyak is at once a hockey player and an army officer.
Somebody died during these battles.
И поэтому...
To break the ice, Vlad and Titania invite the Gretzky boys for dinner.
Скоро мне придется тренировки. Что-то не так хочется.
Titania was nervous cooking a meal for North American boys. How are they going to like Russian sausage, chicken Kiev, caviar and vodka? Bread and salt, the traditional Russian greeting for honored guests.
Добро пожаловать в мой дом. Очень рад, что приехал ко мне канадский.
I'm very glad that
канадский друг.
Canadian friend came to my house.
И по русскому обычаю, самого дорогого гостя мы встречаем хлеб с солью.
We are welcoming with
Почему?
Bread and peace.
Потому что дороже хлеба, наверное, нет. Вкусно. Много соли.
Brent, Glenn, and Keith have the same respect for Tretyak as others have for their brother.
Finished. That's
76. 76.
This is Olympic
gold. 76.
This is golden medal. 76.
А это 72-й год. Мне было 20 лет.
Я стал, was 20 years
я был самым молодым олимпийским чемпионом.
So he was the youngest Olympic champion
from
in
Russia,
those days.
In those days?
Вообще, from all the, all the world.
His son Dima performs with some aplomb on the piano. But it is his daughter who steals the show. She is not reluctant to perform, but like her father on the ice, she wants to perform alone. Music comes from his stereo system bought in West Germany, as is the TV and videotape recorder. Because of his standing, Vladislav pays only $10 a month for a 4.5-room apartment. It would be sizable even in Manhattan, and like New York, it needs 3 locks on the door.
I think that all the people in Canada, out of every athlete that ever has played or played in Canada.
Из всех спортсменов, которые когда-то выступали в Канаде.
One of the greatest honors would be to have dinner or even meet with Mr. Tretyak and his wife.
Почтут за честь не только посидеть за одним столом с Третьяком, а просто встретиться с ним и с его женой.
Спасибо.
Thank you very much.
And
your mother.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Cheers. Запомните. Если выпил, надо обязательно кушать.
So if you drink, you have to eat.
Okay? Yeah. We have a saying back home: if you eat, don't drink, and if you drink, don't eat. Спасибо.
Wayne tries his first caviar.
Did you like it?
Черный вкуснее, чем
красный.
Немножко, пускай немножко.
Then presses it on girlfriend Vicky.
Just think, Vicky, you'll be having that on the plane on the way back.
Just try a little bite of it, Vicky. You won't even taste it. I'm not kidding. See? I told you. You can't even taste it. You know, I'm a picky eater. I wouldn't tell you I could taste it.
If you can't taste it, why do they eat it?
Because the bread, it's like escargot. You taste escargot? Vic, I wouldn't be eating it if it wasn't good.
I can't look at it, though,
because
it looks
so bad.
If he ever had a chance or an opportunity to play in Canada,
если бы у вас был случай или возможность играть в Канаде, в национальной хоккейной лиге,
what team would he would like to play?
За какую бы команду ты хотел играть?
Я раньше за Монреаль.
So earlier, you know, for Montreal Canadiens.
No, сейчас за
Эдмонтон. But now for Edmonton.
Вся команда ЦСКА болеет за Монреаль.
No. All the players of the Red Army Club are the fans of Montreal Canadiens. I'd like to propose a toast.
За хоккей.
To hockey. Long live hockey.
Который объединяет друзей.
To unite all friends, all the nations in the world.
Cheers.
The morning after, at the Central Red Army Sports School, a nationwide shortage of sticks and skates hampers the mass of Soviet kids playing the game, as does a chronic shortage of indoor hockey arenas.
Isn't there a picturesque thing, man?
It's estimated that while the Soviets have built perhaps 75 indoor hockey arenas, Canada alone boasts at least 2,200. When a fuss was made about Soviet drills prior to the 1972 series, Wayne wondered why. He observed that Walter had been teaching those drills all his life. But where the Soviets still leave North American hockey behind is their emphasis on dry land training, with sets of exercises for sculpting muscles needed on the ice. Even the Gretzky boys are hard put to keep up with Soviet boys the same age. Something as basic as a somersault gives Brent trouble. And brings a helping hand from Wayne. What is mastered in the gym is then applied on the ice, where knowing how to fall can save serious injury.
It's done for, you know, better coordination.
Значит, заключается смысл игры забить этот мяч руками, только руками.
Use only hands to play this game, and you should score the goal with your hands.
Разрешаются любые силовые приемы.
Any body checking is allowed.
Только, конечно, не драться.
No fighting.
А так можно любым путем ее.
So your aim is to score the goal.
What the Soviets learned from the 72 series was that to keep up with the North Americans, you needed drills to teach toughness and quick thinking under pressure. Hours are spent on drills which teach stick handling in a crowd, passing, pass receiving, and shooting. Only at 10 does regular competition begin.
Progress has been made in North America, but throwing a six-year-old into a game where he learns by the seat of his pants is still too often the approach. Commissars who run Soviet hockey were skeptical when it was suggested Walter Gretzky give a hockey clinic at the Red Army School. What could a backyard coach with no NHL experience teach them?
Okay, this time we're going to do a skating drill. We're going to move on command of the stick. Okay, let's go. Right. Over. Down. Up. Forward! Okay. No cheating sideways. Come on, Glenn, you're holding everybody up. In hockey, you must use every means at your disposal. What we're going to be practicing today is going into the corner. It's a very important part of the game.
So whenever you see the puck go into the corner, you always go in there as fast as you can.
Oh, he did it perfect.
Got that shoulder, right?
As it ended, one Soviet coach called Walter Gretzky North America's secret weapon.
You'll drop your shoulder one way and come out the other.
He says the Soviets bank on opponents from across the Atlantic having scant training in these skills, the kind polished on a backyard rink in Brantford. Tretiak marvels at Wayne's strategic wizardry.
Gretzky played in loops from behind the net. We could not figure out who was supposed to pick him up. I think it's a very new thing in Canadian hockey. They scored many times during the Canada Cup. It was very tough for our guys. For a goalkeeper, when he cannot see the net, this technique makes it very complicated. That's why, training for the Canada Cup, many teams practice to stop it. And now, in our national championships, we ourselves are doing what he does.
Tretiak agreed to pass back some lore of his own and for the first time show the drills that have made him the best goaltender in hockey.
I'd rather go in the corners.
As a boy, we watched a Cossack dance troupe and thought the exercise perfect for a goaltender. As he gets old, they're growing desperate to replace him. Tretiak questioned Wayne closely about the perks and pay of an NHL player. Tretiak secretly was delighted when he was drafted by the Montreal Canadiens. But persuading the Soviets to let him go, even for a while, has been more difficult than arms negotiations.
Very good man.
We're better on floor than hockey.